Good evening, friends. Today we have an endowment program in the name of late Justice Sri B. Vasudevamurthy Endowment Program. Justice Vasudevamurthy started his career as an advocate. He was appointed government leader and was promoted to the post of Advocate General. He was appointed as judge of the High Court of Mysore. He was involved in the cooperative movement and was the president of Mysore State Cooperative Union. He was also president of the Rotary Club. He was legal advisor to Mysore Bank currently before nationalization. He was also a student of philosophy. He was a member of the executive committee of our Indian Institute of World Culture. Srimati Indirabai Vasudevamurthy, wife of Justice Sri B. Vasudevamurthy, instituted this endowment program in the year 1974. The first lecture was held in 1975. This is the oldest endowment program of our Indian Institute of World Culture. On behalf of Indian Institute of World Culture and also on behalf of all of us present here, I welcome the members of the Justice Vasudevamurthy if they are present here. And I also welcome you all to this program. Today we have a lecture program on mental health. Actually, this Justice Vasudevamurthy, the members of the Justice Vasudevamurthy family wanted the people to know more about the mental health. That's the reason why we have chosen this subject. It says Subhash is from Hiriyur and is currently a resident of Bangalore. He has a deep interest in literature, science, psychology and spirituality and engages himself in giving talks, anchoring, writing articles on the topics of his interest. Having a bachelor's degree in science and a master's degree in cognitive neuroscience, coupled with good communication skills, he is often employed in teaching young minds. He frequently delivers lectures on brain connected with life at several organizations in and out of Bangalore. His interest in the field has got him many opportunities to learn and work with the scientific communities of Defense Institute of Physiology and Allied Sciences, DRDO, Delhi, and also National Institute of Advanced Studies in the Indian Institute of Science campus at Bangalore. He is now working as a counselor at National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, NIMHANS, Bangalore. He has received many awards and honors. Interviewed by All India Radio on account of National Science Day 2020, he has received Young Achiever Award, Guest of Honor Rotary, Literary Championship JSSAHR, Kalashree Award, Vayamin Murthy Endowment Prize Psychology from Bangalore Science Forum, winner of the Great Debaters of 2013, received from the Honorable Chairman of the Vidhan Sabha, received a prize from the Honorable Governor of Karnataka for an article in Vanam Mahotsava, published articles in several Kannada newspapers and magazines. He has delivered talks as a resource person and trainer at RBSK, RKSK, NTPC and other institutions of National Health Mission, Government of Karnataka and several schools, colleges and public organizations. So he is a young mind. He is talking about mental health. So on behalf of the Indian Institute of World Culture and also on behalf of all of us present here, I heartily welcome H.J. Subhash. Our present President Vijay Prasad is here with us. I request him to garland him. I now request Subhash to deliver his lecture.
Good evening, everyone. So it's very nice to see a lot of you people turned up to this talk in spite of the pandemic. And I'm very happy to see a lot of seniors among the crowd. You know, most of you have worked in a lot of institutions, have gained a lot of experience. And it's a very great experience to me as a youngster to be speaking in front of all of you. So today, I firstly thank all of the members of Indian Institute of World Culture for giving me this opportunity, and especially the members of Justice Shri B. Vasudev Murthy Endowment. So over to the talk now. So the talk, when sir asked me about what would be the title, then I thought, okay, let's have mental health, which could be connected to the Indian Institute of World Culture and the age group of the audience. Let's say, let's mingle all these things and put into one good thing which would be interesting to all of us. And then I thought of this title, which might have made most of you a little curious. Mental Health and the Modern Day Chitragupta. This title, what did you think? What came to your mind? Anybody want to volunteer and say something? What did you think of it?
Karma.
Okay, that's interesting.
Judgment.
Yes.
Judgment.
Judgments. And what more were the thoughts that came into your mind?
With the social media, I thought.
Social media. Okay. Some of them made this guess. They thought maybe the modern Chitragupta could be meant about social media. Okay. So today I'll reveal the lecture what I meant to be the modern Chitragupta. But before that, it is very important to be talking about mental health, which will actually help us to understand this concept of Chitragupta. So the subtitle is The Impressions We Make. We make into our own lives. Now, when we look into today's presentation, we are going to discuss about why mental health is important, status of mental health in the Indian society today, and thoughts about how we can all together make it better. And finally, I come to who this modern day Chitragupta actually is and what is his relevance with the mental health. So first and foremost, every time we want to discuss about mental health in the current state of India, the National Mental Health Survey, which was taken by NIMHANS, the place where I work, played a very big role. The World Health Organization's definition of health includes physical, social, spiritual and mental health, and not just merely the absence of disease or infirmity. Okay? Most of the time we think being healthy is absence of disease, right? But that is not the whole thing. Being healthy should actually have keep your relationships healthy, your social connections, your spiritual IQs, you know, your mental health and all of this. So when National Mental Health Survey took place in NIMHANS, you know, thousands of professionals went across to all the states in the country, and then they interviewed nearly 40,000. They interviewed 39,575 people, and they found out that nearly 50% of Indian adults, those above 18 years, are in need of active interventions for one or more mental health issues. So it's very surprising. We think mental health conditions are in very less people. Only few need counseling or few need neurological support or whatever. But this finding was very shocking, and it was an eye-opener to most of us, which means 15% of the adult population would come across to 15 crore people in India need mental health support. Do you know what is the actual number of people who seek support or taking treatment? Can anyone guess?
Less than 1%.
Not even half of them.
5 to 6%.
Yes, only 3 crore people. I mean, which is very insignificant compared to the population of country. Like, you know, it's only 3% of people who are into treatment now. Okay, so this is the condition of mental health in the country, and it is not just in India. A lot of countries with different cultures, different educational levels, there is a little stigma about mental health. And you know, we should really appreciate the Endowment and the IIWC for having a talk on mental health. You know, this might actually help a lot more people to come out and seek help. You know, at least if that 3 crore people in the next 5 years become 6, or at least reach half of the mark of people who need interventions, it would be of great importance, because when we actually look at health, there is no health without mental health. You know, why mental health should have a lot of importance, as per the Global Burden of Disease report, mental disorders account for 13% of total disability adjusted life years lost for people with disability. See, when someone is ill or when someone is having a chronic health condition, their part of life years, you know, a certain number of years of their life become unproductive, right? In all such years, 13% accounted to just disability adjusted life years for people going through mental health problems. So that is a huge number that it has to be resolved. Now, why this is so important? That mental health doesn't only limit to depression or individual productivity or individual performance at workplace or family. It has a lot of other complications. It can have an impact on the economy that way, because the person who is earning will be very much impacted by his own mental health. And it's not only that person, because his whole family will be impacted when somebody is having a mental health issue. Not just the person who is having that issue, but whole of his family will be suffering. Now, going ahead of this, what happens is a lot of social crimes, antisocial personality disorders are part of mental health issues. So all these actually result in an unhealthy society. You know, some person who is having any sort of mental health issue may actually develop antisocial personality disorders, antisocial performances. All of this will have a lot of impact on one another. So that is why somebody's mental health, you know, if someone says, sir, my cancer is limited to me only, so it has nothing to do with you, I agree. But if someone says my mental health problems are limited to only me and nobody else around has a say about it, no, we can't agree, because mental health problems are not contagious, but then they have an impact on other people. Now, conditions related to the brain and mind are acknowledged to be on the increase in the recent times. So if we look at the number of cases that we are seeing, even if we see our enhanced OP data, the number of patients that are coming into are increasing every year. This doesn't only mean that the number of cases are just increasing, but at the same time, this is probably also due to the growing awareness. Like if we see recently, there have been a lot of talks, lot of people talking about mental health, and while Sir was mentioning about social media, even if you see, there is a lot of awareness things that are happening about mental health in the social media, and people are accepting it. That is very important. Only the moment someone accepts their mental health condition, they will seek help. You know, once society normalizes it, once society accepts people with mental health disorders and their family members without raising a stigma towards it, you know, it becomes very easy for people or their family members to seek help or counseling. And this could also be about improved recognition, variations in disease patterns, changing lifestyles and biological vulnerabilities, consequently depression, anxiety, alcohol and any other substance use, and suicidal behaviors, drug use, sleep disorders and several others are also on increase. Now, if you see, we all had recently been suffering from a pandemic, COVID. If you see, COVID does not exist as a physical health condition, but a lot of people who were suffering from coronavirus also needed active counseling. You know, it was very encouraging for a lot of patients when they were able to undergo for a counseling, when they were able to talk to a counselor. Because now if you see, like when I mentioned variations in disease patterns, so a lot of, now there is oncopsychiatry, you know, there is a counseling for people who are going through cancer or various other cancer-related issues. And now there is a counseling process for people undergoing COVID. So the changes in disease patterns is also helping us to get a lot of cases, which may not be technically the increase, but still, these are the other things. And also if you see the substance use, you know, substance use has also become very common in these days, where we have successfully normalized the habits of substance use, be it smoking, alcohol or whatever it be. So there is a need for counseling for all these people. If someone is going through substance use disorders or a serious substance dependence, in Nimhans we also have a center where we actually give them counseling, and we also give them treatment and medication. So substance use disorders are also on high. So mental health doesn't only talk about depression or anxiety, but it has all these things. We call it MNSUDs, which is mental, neurological and substance use disorders. All these constitute the mental health of a person. So going ahead, so what is very important to be known is nobody is an exception. There has been a lot of stigma when it comes to grouping people to be out of a mental health condition as like, okay, certain cultural groups won't get it. Someone who is rich may not have a depression. Someone who is very well educated need not be suffering from mental health conditions. Someone who is well read, someone who is spiritual need not be having a mental health condition. Anything, we had a lot of stigma. But what is in the reality is, irrespective of person's demographic differences, which is age, gender, whatever, or urban, rural, people may suffer from mental health conditions. And irrespective of economic status, you know, I have heard people from saying, Vananda, you have a lot of riches, you can solve any problem. Why are you depressed? Why are you low? You know, any problem can be solved by you. Why are you anxious? In all such conditions, we should understand that economic status is also no